Analytics with Nags. This is another video in the Catch Up with Nags series where I'm going to discuss about Power BI August 2021 updates. Without wasting our time, let's begin our today's topic. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin. So we are in this Microsoft official Power BI portal where I will walk you through what are the different things available in this August 2021 release, and we will parallelly try to check it out in the Power BI as well. So first thing is all about reporting, like customized shape formatting. So what it indicates, it's like there are different shapes available. They have added new shapes in Power BI. Like you can go to the insert and you can see different shapes, and there are a lot of formatting options available for it. That is what they meant. So here you can check the rotations, and you can do the coloring, other formatting options. That is the customized shape format. And X-axis constant line improvement, this is all about some constant line, inserting a constant line in Power BI reports. So where it will be available, right? So let me walk you through it. So where we need to have a line chart, and you can use the date over here, date column, and you use any one of the measure item quantity, so you will get different values over here, right? So say for example you are setting some targets for on January 2020. The data is old, bear with me. So let me increase the size if you want. So I will slightly increase the size. So you have set some target, or you have some important dates coming over here, you want to check the trend, how it is behaving, or it can be a future dates, or it can be the old dates, right? So for that, till now you do not have a version to create a constant line in x-axis, whereas you have option to create in the y-axis, like horizontal line. I mean, you do not have an option to create a vertical line like this. So as soon as you put the dates here, you get the new option here. I hope it was available, but they improved some performance improvements. So you just add a column and you can able to pick up a date, or you can write a DAX function that is dynamically creates some dates for you. So right now I go for some default date. Let me go to 2020 January, some date over here, right? So as soon as you see here, you have your constant line, and you can check some different colors, and you have something like shadow before or after. So before means this, and after means after this color, and you have an option to change the lines. So what is the business impact of it? We will discuss in a separate video. And this is what a constant line means. And this is not applicable when you do not have your date access here. What I'm trying to say is when I remove it, right? So as soon as you remove it, you want to analyze by category, you do not have a X constant line. This is applicable only for the date field. So this is about X constant line improvement. And then default sensitivity label policy in Power BI Desktop. In our previous release, like July, we have discussed the sensitivity label, what it means, and they are going to make it as default option in Power BI Desktop. So let's move on to the modeling part. So new way of expressing date and time. So there is earlier you have to stick to some date format, and here now you have some flexible ways to set your date and date format. You can go through it, like the example over here will explain it to you. So now you can see DAX supports valid date time components with fewer digits than indicated for you each of you. For instance, January can be specified either 1 or 0, right? So this way you have flexibility to specify some date formats. Then evolution configuration settings. So this is another important factor, like you loading table simultaneously. When you load the table simultaneously, maximum number of simultaneous evolution, you can set this configurations. So this is another very good feature, like when importing data, when using a direct query by loading tables simultaneously. So this will be very good improvement when you use the direct query. So these are the most important part I like in this release. And other things are connector update. There are some issues, and those things are fixed, or it can be some kind of security or something missing. They have updated those connectors. Then coming to the visuals, you can see all these new visuals over here. And here you see the colleague by cloud space. Like you have visual, you can represent it as different images, and based on that you can analyze. And also another visual over here is like a BLPM, like process M, where it shows like different processes you are undergoing. You see that art stat is 1104, and after that it is registered the same count, and analyzing the defect from that count, then it split it into two. Inform the user 11102 and 8785 repair the sample. So how the process is flowing, like, so this is one of the visual I liked in this release. So you can go through other visuals released in this August 2021. I hope you like this video. If you like it, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. And do remember that data is your asset.